Okay, great. Still good quality though, yeah?
The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
Oh, I love the sidestep movement, it's so realistic.
The Northmen speak of 9 worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of Earth, Harvest, Wind, and Sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim. And that is where you must travel.
Don't kill me. I'm not one of them.
Don't listen.
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way.
Don't listen.
I'll never let the bastards catch me again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Drew? Is that you?
My tales of the Northmen. They call me Druth. Liar. An old fool. Druth is my truth.
Hmm? It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell. If I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
The gate.
Gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it
be? It works.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listen? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? We are always here. I guess it's the same with heights. You can stand on the edge, pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
Daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead.
The living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him.
I don't know what the controls are. Just making it up.
They're
vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time.
Traumatic. The dark rot will grow each time you fail. The rot reaches Senua's head, her quest is over. And all progress will be lost. Whoa. Did I actually just die then?
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every
it's a bit
defeat,
like Sekiro, isn't it? Dragon rot.
The dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
Sec. Control.
It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't she open it? She needs to challenge the gods.
She has to fight two gods first.
Two gods?
Two gates.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it. Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Thor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the Old Father.
What's that? It's a wall. It's a door.
No, it's a bitch.
No, it's not.
Jeez.
Push it. Push it down.
What do you think will happen?
Come on.
She did it.
Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Gaze into the relentless darkness. All that lurks within it can see you too. Stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much has changed. It's all different now.
break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
It's got a Shadow of the Colossus kind of feel to it, like the originality, like the attention to detail. It's more about the atmosphere than the actual kind of the gameplay.
Where the forest itself is watching.
Definitely the atmospheric feel. It's the draw of the game, isn't it? To kind of suck you in. Very realistic. Essentially, you are the character, you have a weapon, and the rest is just atmosphere.
Another gate.
Another gate. You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it. It's not safe. Don't listen.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
It's a little bit Silent Hill-esque as well, in a way. Just, again, just atmosphere. I kind of get that feel. It's more about the environment than anything else.
Senua. To purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now.
She can get up now.
What's happening? She can get up now.
How can she get up?
It must be
magic.
Dark magic.
A trick.
Raven. Tricking her.
Raven.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him. Dark magic draws her closer.
Raven's magic.
It's not him.
He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own.
He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Like the texture on the wall looks like you're underwater. It's the light filtering through.
Just because you cannot see the threat.
Nice detail.
It doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Val Raven, he's there.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Binaural aspect to the audio is amazing. Like, I can hear the rain behind me.
This reminds her of somewhere.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left here.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to
Fez, how's it going,
her
mate?
Own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did Shout out to Fez.
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness.
Yeah, really good that, mate. I'm just totally absorbed in this game at the minute. It's a silent stream.
She wanted to beat her own darkness and marry a dream.
But it didn't work.
It's a vibe stream.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Hey, Fez. Juno's gifted. Thanks, Juno. easy clapper. 1 year. Subscribe to tier one. Easy clap. How you doing, mate?
Say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and he gathered them in his mind.
Fez is gifted to Lion's Eye. So cool, thank you. Struggling with this one. Figured it out. Figured it, I think. Clever boy. Clever boy. The girl. Oh man, this is going to be tricky. Oh dear. Does that just create more symbols? Maybe I meant to clear them up. Is that what I meant to do? Instead of... I'm trying to create options when I should be... I'm creating more options than what I need. Maybe I need to simplify it. Is that it? I guess that's why there's so many there in the first place. See, you don't know until you try, do you? I mean, I'm still probably wrong, but...
The ravens. They've gone. No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some of them
there. Ravens help you.
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Just take me a while to get my head around things. I don't want to feel too pressured, I just want to enjoy the game, so...
The ravens.
They've all gone.
No.
There's still three.
There's three.
That's it.
Where have they gone?
They're gone.
She did it. What does it mean?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought. Grew in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion, the fierce in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to Hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
The gate is open!
It's open!
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
I'm still here. Are you too? I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom. Drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness,
Senua,
and she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Ah!
isn't it? They've surrounded her.
She's not strong enough.
Sugar.
Stronger than you.
Behind you.
Behind you.
Focus!
Focus now! Focus! 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 Focus!
Valravan, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming. I still hear you.
Stunning game. Stunning. The action was really intense. I was so sucked into that. I was really focused and sucked into that. Wow, I feel like I can breathe. It's really tense. Wow. The graphics coming out of that are just unreal. The detail.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And then she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. In the trees. The mountains. Caves.
Senua, you have the sight, just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother, Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over. She misses her so much.
She needs to go back.
She can't.
It won't open.
Why won't it open?
Why won't it open?
There's another challenge. There's another challenge.
Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow. But you weren't expecting that.
What?